Hey guys, I'm Siobhan, a second year medical resident. Today we're going through a very requested video, and that's emergency codes in the hospital. You guys have heard them overhead, you've been a part of them in some of my other videos.
Code blue, level one.
Code yellow is being called, so that's for a missing person. And the question is, what do they all mean and what are they all for? So let me know in the comments below if you've ever heard an emergency code like that overhead, or if it means something slightly different in the hospital that you work at. Across the world, people use these emergency codes in the hospitals. I live in Canada, and I'm in the province of Ontario, and across Ontario, they've actually standardized the majority of emergency codes. There may be some little extra ones that are site-specific, but for the most part, no matter where you work, you'll know what it means. Okay, so let's dive right in. Code orange is an external disaster. So something outside the hospital has happened, and we expect a whole bunch of patients to be coming to the hospital. Basically like Grey's Anatomy when they have all those catastrophes, like a ferry sinking or a train accident, things like that. But instead of going out into the field, we're getting prepared for the patients to come. And that actually happened last year. So here's a clip from last year that I never ended up showing you guys. Hey guys, it's Sunday night, it's about 7 o'clock. I just got an email saying that there's a code orange. In this case, there's a fire at one of the nursing homes. So they're asking for all of us to come in at short notice, just come in right now tonight, because we have a whole bunch of patients who are going to be showing up at the hospitals. So I'm just getting myself ready to head in, and I just really, really hope that there aren't too many people who've been injured. Honestly, I was so impressed with everyone at the hospital. There were probably about 30 residents who came within less than an hour to the hospital to be able to admit 100 patients. 100 patients all at once coming is a huge amount of work. So administrators, nurses, doctors, everyone pulled together to find a place to be able to care for and treat these patients. So code black. This is a suspicious object or it's an actual bomb threat. So really scary. Obviously we don't hear this often. I've never heard it. I hope to never hear it ever. But because we're not gonna be as familiar, there's actually a protocol that's kept at the nursing desk so that we can open it up if there is a code black ever. Anyway, can't even imagine that. It's terrifying. Code blue. Now this is a medical emergency. This is where I jump to action. It's when a patient's heart has stopped, so a cardiac arrest, or when they've stopped breathing, a respiratory arrest. Or it can actually be when people are worried that's about to happen, or a patient's gotten really sick really quickly and you want more help in the hospital, you call a code blue. So when I'm in the hospital working away, seeing patients, and I hear an announcement and they start saying code, you can just feel everyone kind of pauses for a second and is waiting. And if they say blue, all of a sudden you snap into action. And this is a real team activity. And a lot of people are showing up to these. You've got respiratory therapists, anesthesia, nursing, residents, medical students, they all flood into a room to help. As the senior medical resident, so me, I'm the team leader. So I stand at the foot of the bed and you're organizing what everyone's doing and you're the one giving orders and giving medications and telling people to do CPR and intubate and all of that. You are the captain of the team. So it's a very high stakes time. We're trying to bring someone back to life often. So if you want me to go in depth and really tell you all about what a code blue is like and what we're doing, just let me know in the comments below, give this video a thumbs up. So that'll be the sign to me that you guys want me to make that video. Code silver, another scary code. This means there's an active shooter or someone with a gun or suspected gun. So again, never heard this, never want to. Very scary stuff. Code omega. So, okay, it's not a color and it's not actually a code in all hospitals, but I've been a part of a number of them. And it's basically to let people know that there is so much blood loss from a person that it's life threatening. And it's a way to get the blood bank, the staff, the porters, everyone working together and having good communication to get a bunch of blood products to that person to try to save their life. The first time I ever was part of a code omega was in medical school, and I was on my eMERGE rotation down in the eMERGE, and a young guy had been in a motorcycle accident and he broke his pelvis. And if you break your pelvis, you can just bleed into your back. We call it the retroperitoneal space. It's this area in the back that can hold liters and liters of fluid. And what ended up happening is he was bleeding so much that we pumped 30 units of blood products into this patient to try to stabilize him enough to get him to the operating room. And that did happen. It was incredible to see. And the way you get so much blood products in at once is using something called a level one transfuser. So you pop different bags of blood products in and they kind of squeeze them down so that the blood product can get in really quickly in a fast transfusion into the person. Code Brown. This is actually a hazardous spill in the hospital. I mean, okay, a code brown. I mean, if you look this up on Urban Dictionary or just like talk about it with people, it would mean something very different. So I don't know, it's kind of a funny code, or the name of the code's kind of funny. Maybe I'm immature. Code red. So this is fire. Unless you actually are in the area, so usually they announce where the code red is located. So unless you're in that area, you just close the doors and windows and you wait for further instruction. So you're not actually evacuating until you hear code green. And now I think green for go. So that's when you're actually going to leave the hospital. You're evacuating at this point. Code aqua is a flood. I have heard that one. I don't know where that was or what was going on, but then the code was called off and it didn't really affect my day, so I don't have a story there. Code yellow. So this is a missing person, or missing patient, really. And this happened to me when I was on call and I was vlogging with you guys, and it ended up triggering a whole bunch of comments and questions about whether a patient decided to leave the hospital, if this would automatically trigger a code yellow. So to answer that, it's not about a patient leaving so much as it's about whether the patient is competent. So can the person make a decision for themselves? Can they say the pros and the cons and understand the risks involved with leaving the hospital when they're still sick? So if you can tell me very reasonably, these are the reasons and I'm going and I don't care if something bad happens to me, well, I can't stop you if you're competent. So at that point, it would be leaving AMA, so against medical advice. And that happens. But just imagine someone had meningitis, they've got an infection in their brain, they don't know where they are, they're confused. If they left, maybe they'd run into traffic and get hit by a car. We have to protect these patients who aren't able to make decisions for themselves because they're too sick or they're not able to think clearly for one reason or another. And that's when we call a code yellow, because they're not competent. We have to get people to look for them and for their own safety. And if we can't find them in the hospital, we get police involved to actually bring them back to the hospital. So it's a really big ordeal. Code white. This is a violent person. That could be a patient, that could be a family member, but it's people are feeling unsafe in the hospital because of someone's actions. And it's usually in the emergency department, in the psychiatry wing, but it can really happen anywhere. And in fact, this has happened to me a couple of times where I was physically intimidated or people were yelling at me, and I really felt unsafe. You feel nervous, and we have to be treating everybody. You have to treat every patient, and sometimes violence is actually a symptom of their disease or their illness, whether that's mental or physical. And so you have to treat everyone, but you also have a right to feel safe in your workplace. And often all it takes is a code white, security guards come, they look, you know, big and burly in their uniforms and they stand there. And sometimes that, in showing strength in numbers, is enough to calm someone down. It also gives you backup so that you feel safe, because you should never be harmed at work. So those are the main codes. Thanks so much for watching, and if you want to know really in detail what goes on in the code blue, let me know in the comments below, and if you're interested, I'll make that video. So if you want to see me vlogging in the hospital with a code blue, check this one out. And if you want to see a code yellow, check this one out. Otherwise, I'll be back in the hospital vlogging again next week, so don't forget to subscribe if you don't want to miss any of those. I'll chat with you guys next week, so bye for now.